Hey guys, this is Raghav, and today I want to share with you my experience of building my first ever successful open source project. Why did I do it? How did I get started? Did I make any money from it? What did I learn from all of it? And what's my advice to those of you looking to get into open source or trying to build a side hustle with software? I'll be talking about my project called Etlint. It's on my GitHub repo. Quick introduction, Etlint is a linter for a programming language called Solidity. So essentially, it's a command line application which you run on your terminal, and when you run it over some Solidity code, like a code base or even just a single file, Etlint will scan that code and it will flag all the bad practices you're using in terms of style and security. And it also offers to automatically fix some of those practices. And what is Solidity? Solidity is a programming language which helps you create decentralized applications on the Ethereum blockchain. That's a very loaded statement, but the idea is that Solidity is yet another programming language which lets you create backend apps, right? And instead of running on servers, these apps run on the blockchain, specifically the Ethereum blockchain. Now, to watch this video, you don't need to know anything about the blockchain ecosystem. All you need to know is that I created an open source project, which is a linter for a programming language, just like ESLint is for JavaScript. Now, at its peak, my project had over 10,000 downloads per week. It was being used by over 2,000 open source projects on GitHub and some of the leading companies in the blockchain ecosystem who were developing Solidity applications were relying on Etlint. I even received a big grant for it thanks to the Ethereum Foundation. So how on earth did I even arrive at this point? I started building Etlint back in 2016 when I was in the second year of my college. Back then, I had already done a lot of coding and I was just writing some random applications in Python and Node.js. I was building things like tic-tac-toe game or a to-do application or an email application. But all of this was very unsatisfactory because, yeah, it helps you polish your skills, but it was like solving a problem which has already been solved like a million times before. It was making no real impact, and I am the sort of person who, if he doesn't see impact in doing something, then I don't see the point of doing that. This is why I've also found doing data structures and algorithm questions to be a complete waste of time. Even studying chemistry in college was a very painful time for me because I was sitting and thinking that, okay, am I going to spend 4 years of my life learning but not really adding any real value? Because yeah, don't get me wrong, learning is very beneficial, learning is very important, but 4 years, no real world impact was a bit unsettling. So I wanted to spend my time building something that would solve a problem for someone. Like, even if I could build some software that would solve a problem for just 5 people, I would be super happy. The only problem was I just did not have any idea on what to do. And this is a dilemma I face very often, even till today, and I think I'm going to face it for the rest of my life. There's a bunch of tasks to do, but I wouldn't do them because I know that there is no real world value added by doing those tasks, right? But the things that I would like to do, I don't really have any idea on how to make them useful. So to deal with this, I took one philosophy which I have applied many times in my life and I will continue to apply it. What works in some other part of the world might also work here in my world. Now, this is a pretty useful philosophy, but also a very dangerous one. And that's probably a discussion for another video. For now, all you need to know is that, yes, I was actually thinking of copy-pasting something. And I didn't really worry about will I get users or not, because the worst case scenario is I just don't get any users, but I would still create something new and it would be fun. So it'd be a good engineering thing. So at that time, because I was writing a lot of JavaScript, I was using a lot of ESLint to lint my JavaScript code. At the same time, I also started getting really interested in developing Solidity applications on the Ethereum blockchain because building blockchain apps became the new hot thing in tech back then. And it was a very new and upcoming ecosystem, the blockchain ecosystem. So there were not a lot of developer tools and stuff like that did not exist for them. People were just bringing together hacks to do stuff. Okay. So I thought, why not do for Solidity what ESLint did for the JavaScript community? And that's how I began working on a linter for Solidity called Etlint. Well, it was originally called Solium, but then I had some trademark issues with the company and then I had to rename. So the important thing is that I had zero expectations when I started building this tool. I did not want to make something big. I wasn't expecting to make any money out of it. I decided that I was going to be happy if a couple of people started using it. And that's all. No expectations beyond this. I was just a college kid who wanted to work on a fun and new and exciting project. And this was very exciting for me. But working on a code analyzer actually sent me down a very deeply technical path of understanding how language parsers actually internally work. How they take your source code and convert it into tokens. And then create a more useful data structure, which we call abstract syntax trees. And then how you can perform a depth-first traversal on those trees to actually conduct the real analysis on the code. Learning all of this blew my mind. And guys, this is the real-world data structure and algorithms problems, and I would any day prefer to work on this than on some random shortest path question which takes me 1 hour to solve and makes zero dent in the universe. So, I analyzed the architecture of ESLint, then built a prototype of my project, and over time, proved that this analyzer could also work for Solidity. In this whole process, I also ended up collaborating with a lot of people from the blockchain open source community, and you would be surprised by how helpful and nice and friendly these people are and how welcoming they are when you, as a new person, want to join their community. So after working for almost 6 months, I finally published the first version of ETHLint, which was already useful. It was already starting to catch some issues in the code bases, which was frankly good enough. And since it was good enough, I decided that I wanted to start promoting the project. I wanted at least a few people to start using it, and I wanted to see if actually they are benefiting from it or not. So I published my project on GitHub in a repository and also published its NPM package. I also polished everything, the README, the documentations and stuff like that. So the packaging looks good. Then I started to promote it. And this is where the real challenge began for me, because as an engineer, coding came easy to me. It was fun, but I had zero clue how to promote my project. And that is when I learned that marketing is perhaps one of the most important skills that you can teach yourself. Market yourself or market your projects, market your work, doesn't matter, but marketing. And I did a variety of creative things to get people to use my project. I was going to Stack Overflow to answer questions which were relevant to what I was doing. And then I would also recommend my project in it. I would also post on LinkedIn and then talk to people in the comment section to raise more awareness about it. I even made a lot of pull requests to get ETHLint added to a variety of GitHub projects. Documentations, awesome lists, stuff like that. I even went to Discord channels to take part in conversations and then tell people about what I was working on. But throughout this process, I was also transparent. I made it very clear that this is a free open source project and I am not making any money out of it. This was a major factor that so many people also supported me. And you know what? All this marketing effort paid off. After a while, I started seeing what was perhaps the best feeling in my life. I started seeing real users, people using my project on their code basis and relying on what my project was doing for them so that they would change their code based on what my project's recommendations were to them. And slowly the downloads also started increasing. But what was most important to me was that people were spending their precious time on something that I created. This was an amazing feeling. The project started to put me on the map in the developer ecosystem of blockchains. People started to create pull requests, issues, and I got a lot of stars on my repository, and all of this really encourages you. And this cycle then continued. I continued to talk to my users, get more feedback, go back, build more, fix issues. I even did a full rewrite of the project in between just to make the architecture more pluggable so people could then develop their own plugins and write their own style and security linting rules and then plug them in. And with each iteration, the project became more and more useful. Now, one morning, I woke up to 30 new pull requests on my project. And this was a time when I would get like an occasional 2 or 3 pull requests in a month. And overnight, I had 30 new pull requests. There was a sudden burst of discussions on the project and a lot of people were participating. And suddenly, I had no idea what to feel. And I got so excited and scared at the same time because the project was getting so much attention. But at the same time, I had like all this code to review and either merge or reject and questions to answer and features to support. But honestly, I had no idea what was going on. Like, why the sudden burst of pull requests and participation? Because this wasn't a spam. Like, nobody was spamming me. These were all genuine requests and genuine people having genuine discussions. So after about 3 days, I noticed one comment from somebody in a pull request, which mentioned a hackathon. And that's when I got to know that a big company in the blockchain space, who, by the way, uses my project at this point, they created a lot of bounties for adding a lot of rules in my project. They wanted more people to add more linting rules in Ethlint, and so they created more bounties. They were willing to give away cryptos to anybody who was able to merge some useful code in my repository. This was my first breakthrough. It was insane because somebody is paying money to help me build my project. That is how useful it is for them. I was over the moon because this was already way beyond my expectations from the project. And for the first time, as a college kid and as an engineer, I had created something which solved real problems for real people. Simply amazing. So I made a lot of happy memories with Ethlint. But did I ever make any money out of my open source project? One day, I was reading a blog and I happened to see a mention of a grants program by the Ethereum Foundation. And I just decided to send an email to them. That email led to a lot of conversations which ended up in the Ethereum Foundation giving me $10,000 in grants. I told my family that I got $10,000 from the Ethereum Foundation because they wanted to help me build my project. And this was a moment that I would never forget in my entire life. Of course, I had no constant source of income from Ethlint. It was, after all, a free open source project that I was building on my own time. But to start with, that was also never the goal. I never wanted to make money. I just wanted to solve a problem. And I ended up achieving a lot more than what I had intended to. And for that, I have many people to thank. And so this is not just the story of my first big open source project. It is actually the story of the first time I ever became useful to the world. So if there is one thing that I would really like you guys to take away from my video, it's that stop thinking about 10 different things. Just start doing something. If you can't think of something original, just start by copying something else and put your own touch to it. That's exactly what I'm doing with my YouTube channel. Don't worry about clarity. Nobody is ever clear on their goals on day one. The important thing is to just start. Don't waste your time solving problems that have already been solved a million times. Don't spend hours doing data structures and algorithm questions. And don't spend time on creating yet another to-do list application. Solving real-world problems will teach you things that nothing else in life can teach you. Among other things, it will also teach you how to deal with rejection. Trust me, I got plenty of those during my open source journey as well. Make something that people want, and if you want to make money out of that, there's nothing wrong with it. And while you're doing this, have a little patience. I remember reading this line once, and now it lives in my head forever. It goes like, "It took me 20 years to become an overnight success. Solve problems and make the world a better place." Okay, enough sentimental for one video. See you next time.